Hey everyone, welcome. It was a couple of years ago when one of our famous YouTubers had the chance to test some pre-production MTB wireless group set from Wiltop. Now, Wiltop is one of the two Chinese manufacturers trying to break the monopoly of SRAM and Shimano on the wireless group sets. Now, on the mountain biking side, that has been only SRAM, but now Wiltop seems to have production ready parts. EDSDX is their road and gravel group set. I have it with me today, so why don't we take a closer look, see what this brings to the table, and if this leads us to what the future MTB wireless group set might be. Now, I know we're mountain bikers, but who doesn't have at least one road bike or gravel bike or cyclocross bike? Well, behind me, I have the Trek Crockett, which is my multifunctional bike, running GRX 11 speed, all mechanical. And in my hand, I have a 105 lever. This is group set of the people. So I'm gonna just put these components next to the Shimano equivalent, at least to get a flavor of the ergonomics, if nothing else. And one thing that's crazy is that the EDSDX comes in two variants. One is disc brake, so hydraulic disc brake variant. Second one, it's gonna be rim brake, so cable actuated. I have the hydraulic disc brake version with me. This comes in two boxes. Let's see what's inside. The smaller box is the one with the disc brakes. And aside from disc and mineral oil, you're not gonna find anything else here on the box itself. But if we move over to the other bigger box, you have a label here on the side. And interestingly, they seem to have or will have two variants of this. For those of you that are familiar with road group sets, that's an 11 speed group set, the R7000, R7100, that's a 12 speed 105 group set from Shimano. What I have here is what seems to be the 11 speed equivalent. And you can see here, this is the whole group set and I have a part number. Let's go back to the brakes. Inside, you have everything covered in foam. You can see that nice textured surface. And this is a small parts box. You can clearly see here, these would be the adapters or spacers for 140, 160 millimeter rotors. And then you have olive and inserts when you need to cut the hoses, as well as the fixing bolts for these Shimano flat top type calipers, because that's what we have here. This is pretty much what Shimano does with their calipers. You see it here next to my GRX front caliper. Now, this is a better design than what the other Chinese manufacturer, the L2, does. They use a proprietary design for the calipers. Here, the only info is on the side telling you to use mineral oil when you're filling these up. By the way, hoses that you're getting are BH90 type of hoses. They are pre-filled with oil. You just unscrew this and install your olive and insert. And weight of the front with 900 millimeter hose is 163 grams. Rear comes with 1550 millimeters long hose, and that's 176 grams with pads installed. Pad retaining bolt is held in place or secured with that circlip. Make sure you remove it first. Then use a 3 millimeter Allen to remove the bolt itself. And you can remove the pads right from the top. No need to remove the wheel. Here is my GRX pads right next to it. They talk about L04 pad compatibility. This is L05 from Shimano. And if you want to use pads like this with this caliper, look at this, it fits perfectly. So that is actually awesome. By the way, that circlip, it's an absolute pain to install and or remove. But if you are to use the Shimano circlip, that works just fine, just like the pads. So here's an easy upgrade for these calipers for you folks. One thing to keep in mind is that you cannot use the Shimano Olive and insert when installing these hydraulic brakes. So you would have to use what's been sent by Wheeltop. Now, it's hard to get too excited about hydraulic brakes, but I bet my money that you guys can't wait to see the wireless bits. And I'm gonna start this by saying that, yes, we do need an app, and you have the QR code to get to the App Store right here in the back of the big box. Or on the App Store, just search for Wheeltop and get it to install on your phone. And with that done, let's take a look inside. Once again, lots of foam protecting the internals. And here at the bottom, you're gonna have secure code taking you to their website, another option to download the app. And I hope that this was a quick pairing guide. Instead, is a bit of a quick start guide, pretty much telling you to download the app, install the transmission, adjust it, and enjoy your ride. And this is the components, folks. So obviously we're gonna have lever number one. Here's the front derailleur. And here it's gonna be, I assume this is a charging cable. And that should be our rear derailleur with the second charging cable right in there. In that tiny baggie, we got, that's an USB-C adapter and a little washer. I don't know what that is about. There's no charger included, but they specify 5 volts, no more than 2 amps chargers to be used for this. And as you look at the derailleurs, you're gonna find some sort of dust cover like this. That's where the magnetic clip on cable comes in, and you see that red LED over there telling us that this is charging. I assume it's going to turn green once it's done charging. On the rear derailleur, that dust cover is actually here on the back. Same idea, magnetic clip on, and you're going to have the LED right here. Also notice that these batteries are not removable on either one of the derailleurs. Looking at the shifters, one thing that strikes me right away is their size. Specifically, their small size. This is a 105, but this is 105 mechanical. Usually the hydraulic levers are a bit bigger because they have a reservoir full of oil. You can see that hose connection right here, by the way. If anything, the Wheeltop shifter is actually a bit smaller. Here is next to the Shimano GRX. So both of these are hydraulic levers, and the Wheeltop, it's a bit shorter and smaller overall, and the brake lever is a tiny bit shorter also. This is one switch. That's the second switch. They are very different. They feel very different. In here, you're gonna find your reach adjust. And as you peel this silicone cover off, this is where you're gonna see the CR2032 battery. If you're wondering about texture, again, look here next to the 105. I would say it's very similar. Nice grippy surface here. Not much different than what you see on the Shimano lever. If I look at this, the left shifter, this one only has one button installed on it, the same reach adjust inside, the same hose attachment here, and obviously another coin cell battery right here. From the front, you can see the shape, similar, very similar to Shimano, only difference being that I'm pretty sure this is made out of carbon.
And not only that, that carbon makes them look premium, but it also helps with the weight of the levers.
With the right shifter coming up to 222 grams, again, this is pre-filled with oil and you have the battery installed. Left shifter comes up to 221. Look at that.
And carbon is also what they used right up here on the derailleur, and also the cage is made out of carbon. And if you look carefully, you're also gonna see that there is no clutch here on this road specific derailleur. However, this is where the magic happens, and the step motor that's installed here underneath the battery, this guy can be configured to give us anywhere between 3 and 14 speed. This can be adjusted to move in the proper steps. Otherwise, the design of the derailleur is very similar to what you would find right here on the Shimano 105, in that the derailleur cage length, it's pretty much identical, but from there you can see how the wheel top derailleur has a bit of an offset here from that pivot point, which doesn't exist on the Shimano. Shimano uses bushings in the jockey wheels. These guys are rolling on bearings. And also, if you look at the shape of the jockey wheels, you're gonna see that these are 12 tooth, these are 11 tooth. This is more like SRAM inspired. As for the wheel top bottom jockey, you can see that this is a narrow wide tooth profile jockey, again, 12 tooth versus 11. Both of these are considered to be long cage or SGS. You actually see that right here on the wheel top, which means that you can use them with, this is 11 to 34, I think. The wheel top works 10 to 36, which is pretty much the widest cassette, road cassette you can find today. And without the clutch, the strength of that spring could be important. If I compare the two here in my hand, hard to tell if one is stronger or weaker than the other. If anything, this moves a bit smoother throughout its travel, whereas this one hits a spot around here where it becomes a bit stronger in comparison. Obviously, with all the extra mechanisms and electronics bolted on, the wheel top should be or will be heavier, 325 grams with the battery attached, which is not that bad compared to the SRAM Axis, for instance. Just for reference, this one is 227, but remember, you gotta add the housing, the cable, and all that jazz.
And I don't know if you guys are aware of the fact that Shimano 12-speed road uses the same chains, the HG Plus proprietary chains that we use in mountain biking. That bottom narrow wide jockey doesn't seem to have any issues using a chain like that. As for the flat top chains that are used widely by SRAM Road, again, you can see it here working no problem with a chain like that. I assume they've tested it with the 13-speed chain from Campagnolo, and they are confident that whatever 14-speed group set we're gonna have in the future, it's gonna work just fine with their design.
From the derailleur, not that much to say about it, aside from the fact that it seems to be like a 105 front derailleur with a Big Mama battery and motor obviously bolted onto it. These look almost identical in all dimensions. You have a little piece of plastic here, probably to keep the noise down or the rubbing down. You don't have that on the wheel top, but otherwise you have the mounting bolt right here up front, and pretty much everything looks the same. If I am to put these on the scale, you're gonna see the front derailleur, the mechanical, at 95 grams and the wheel top at 189. So again, about 100 grams difference between the pure mechanical 105 and the wheel top parlous version of the derailleur.
Now, straight out of the box, my drivetrain seems to be set up for 2x12. The right shifter provides us with 11 clicks. By the way, the front derailleur can only be a 2x, and in order to adjust the whole system, you have to connect it to the app.
Earlier, I showed you that LED that the derailleur has right here for the charging. There's another LED over here that you're gonna notice once this is in use. And you also have an LED right here at the top of your lever. The front derailleur is no different. You have, see that LED right there. And you also have an LED over here. If I launch the app and I try to find products right in here, so bind successfully and go. You can see pretty much the whole system connected to my phone right away just by adding the rear derailleur.
Now, these devices don't have any additional buttons on them, so when you are to wake them up and connect them to your app, you're gonna have to move them around. That's the way to wake them up. Again, SRAM would have an extra button. They call it the access button on the units themselves. These don't have that. Shifters are now different, so trigger the Bluetooth communication with the button while you're playing with this to keep it awake. You can see here, this one has a firmware version as well. So I'm just gonna update it just like I did with all the rest. Piece of advice, do this first when you get these units. Once in the app, yeah, don't mind some of the translations of these menus because they might not make a lot of sense. Currently I'm on 12 speed. Here you start at 3, you can go all the way to 14. And if you were to play with the initial calibration or micro adjustments, this is where you go and do that. I'm probably gonna do that in an installation video at some point. So what do you guys think about these new wheel-top drivetrains? I don't know about you, but I'm pretty excited to have in my hand something that's not called SRAM or Shimano. They really do need some competition out there. And I love the fact that these guys made a universal drivetrain, one that can be configured for whatever drivetrain you already have and just want to get rid of wires coming out of your shifter and derailleur. Would you guys be interested in something like this? Are you interested in wireless group sets to start with? Let me know in the comments below. The world of road is already there with pretty much all modern group sets coming in some sort of wireless version. As for mountain biking, these guys already have the mountain bike specific group sets on their website. I really hope to be able to get my hands on one of those and put it in front of you. Obviously, haven't had a chance to ride this at all, but I will let you know, guys, what my impressions are first opportunity I have. So once again, let me know if you have any questions about the Wheeltop EDS-TX. Hope you found this useful. Let me know if you have any comments. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And until next time, we'll see you on the trails, or in this case, I'll see you on the road. Cheers, guys. Cheers.